Hi everybody. Today we'll investigate at the best audiophile headphones on the lookout for 2021. I made this rundown dependent on my own assessment, and I'll attempt to help you find the right one for your requirements. To see the most forward-thinking costs and discover more data about these headphones, you can look at the connections in the depiction underneath. Before we start, I have an inquiry for you folks. Which headphones are you utilizing right presently? What's more, what is your assessment on it? Let me know in the remarks. Number 5. Hi-Fi Man Sindara Best, for the cash. By getting rid of the numbering succession, Hifuman have been able to craft a particular pitch for the Sindara that breaks the numbering chain to their past headphones. The Sindara isn't only an iterative upgrade on either, however. Hifuman is pitching two key areas that I think will resonate with Hello There Fi Man fans: assemble and sound quality. All of this is wrapped around the phrase beautiful, which is the literal translation of the word. Sindara accordingly, Hello Fi Man is pitching the new plan to be the best and most durable quality form to date. The structure factor is extremely lucid, with a more reliable matte black shading and a utilization of materials that appear to be better completed and more durable than previously. There is a clear inclination for metal over plastics in the Sindara, and it feels all the better for it. The Sindara is a dual section headphone. As with all their full-sized headphones, be that as it may, the connectors have changed from 2.5mm TRS mono to 3.5mm TRS. You also get a quarter jack converter as an additional accessory. The Sindara's superb transient reaction and dynamic range conveys an accurate and engaging imaging experience inside a fairly spacious soundstage. Assuming names are a thing, the Sindara ought to have more staying power than the past number generation. There's a palatable move forward in both refinement of sound and construct quality on the Sindara over the past generation. That'll stand it in great stead. Number 4. Sennheiser HD660s. Best for the vast majority. The HD600 series from Sennheiser is undoubtedly perhaps the most fruitful audiophile headphone lines at any point created. The HD650 and the HD600 have been around for almost two decades. In any case, they keep on being a favorite amongst audience members. The HD660s rocks the traditional HD600 series chassis. Be that as it may, with a smooth all-matte black completion. Except for the external grills and inner headband, the HD660's body is created almost totally out of plastic. I've possessed several of these Sennheiser headphones throughout the long term, and not once have I had issues with their fabricate quality. The as it were part on this headphone that we'll require replacing is the pads, which wear out amazingly rapidly. You'll probably have to swap the pads out each year or something like that to guarantee that they proceed to convey their planned sound. Sub-bass is ventured down a piece from the mid-bass and rolls off somewhat early compared to a great deal of the more current headphones that have been released since the original HD650's heyday. Still, there is something encouraging and familiar about the HD660's bass presentation. It's a classic sound that's just right. The reality of the situation will become obvious eventually, on the off chance that it tends to be as effective as its classic archetype. In any case, all comparisons aside, it's a great sounding headphone with a sound that functions admirably for practically any sort of music. Number 3. No, if you read the description at top of this one, you'll see there were several improvements put into place. Def much better to buy the 2020 version. Number 2, or on the other hand, Diesel CDX best. Next in line, the Diesel CDX may be an example of a headphone that's fabricated excessively well. The LCDX weighs more than 635 grams, and while a lot of this is because of the magnet structure in place, there's a considerable amount of metal on this headphone as well. Thankfully, the cable is brilliant, being both lightweight and tangle-free with no microphonic issues. Overall, the plan of these headphones is very acceptable. The solace apart from the weight is also astounding. The Ordzell CDX uses a twofold-sided magnetic array along with Aldiz's phaser components. despite its full-sized look and plan, the LCDX is also easy enough to drive. In any case, it does in any case profit with a great headphone amplifier, and I wouldn't run it from a telephone. The LCDX has great detail retrieval and image clarity. A noticeable move forward from lower-valued planar magnetic headphones. The LCDX has the sort of immediacy and snappiness that we ought to anticipate from a very good quality planar magnetic headphone. Everything sounds tight and well-controlled, meaning bass definition comes through emphatically, and it has an easy time handling complex layers and occupied passages. In the event that you want to stand out amongst other sounding audiophile headphones, you should look at the Audi's LCDX. Number 1 Hi-Fi Man Aria. Best overall. As our top pick, we have the Hello There Fi-Man Aria. They have an extremely neutral sound profile with a bit of brilliance. Although they marginally lack pound and thunder, this is possible because of their open back plan. The plan also helps create a wide and spacious sound stage that can really assist with inundating you in your audio. They have predictable audio generation, so you don't have to constantly adjust them to guarantee you hear the same sound each time you use them. The Aria is a planar magnetic headphone, meaning that the diaphragm's pistonic movement that creates sound waves is created by the utilization of a conductive trace along its surface. That's inundated in a magnetic field as gone against a typical moving loop dynamic driver headphones that have a voice cull behind the diaphragm. Yet the important thing to note about the Hi-Fi-Man Aria is that it utilizes magnets on the two sides of the diaphragm. Goal and overall feeling of clarity are without a doubt a portion of the Aria's ideal qualities. The Aria's detail retrieval capabilities are really noteworthy, and it stands its ground against the absolute most settling headphones I've paid attention to. For example, the HD800's Rad Zero and Stelia, the Hi-Fi-Man Aria has been truly enjoyable to pay attention to, and with its tonally accurate easygoing tuning, outstanding solace and amazing technical performance, the Aria has really demonstrated itself to be a sensational headphone.